Hello friends, today we will discuss immune tolerance. So what is immune tolerance? Immune tolerance is a state of unresponsiveness of immune system towards specific antigen. It is also called as self-tolerance. So important that immune system should not mount immune response against self antigen. And to understand that, immune system needs to identify what is self and what is non-self. So once immune system will be able to differentiate between self and non-self, it can mount immune response against non-self, and it should lead to immune tolerance against the self cell. Why this is very important? Why immune system mounts an immune response against self antigen? That is a fundamental question. And we need to understand why that happens. The basis of that is generation of diversity. Immune system and self-recognition is a fundamental principle on which the whole immune system is based. As we can see over here at the Temple of Apollo at Delphi, Greece, there are certain words which are transcribed, and the words are very important. The word itself says that know thyself. Know thyself is fundamental thing, and if you know thyself, then and then you will be able to know non-self. So for immune system, knowing the self and knowing the non-self makes the fundamental difference. For that, as we discuss, generation of diversity plays a very important role. There are two important receptors of acquired immune response. One is B cell receptor or antibody, and other is T cell receptor that are present on T cell. We know B cell and T cells are fundamental cells which lead to acquired immune response. B cell will lead to humoral response, T cell will lead to cellular response. The whole interaction of this B cell and T cell is dependent on the BCR, that is antibody, and TCR, that is present on T cell, which will interact with the foreign antigen. Now, as we know, these are proteins, and once again, they are produced from the gene locus, and germline gene contains several genes which will make up this protein ultimately. So over here we have seen that both antibody and T cell receptor has got various regions like constant region, there are variable regions, and there are hyper variable regions. So basically they are made up of multiple combination of genetic makeup, and if we look at their genome sequence, we can see there are variable genes, there are diversity segments, there are joining segments, and there are genes for constant region, right? So for each protein, there are availability of multiple gene locus. So out of that, during this antibody generation or T cell generation, there happens recombination and allelic exclusion, and unique type of antibody is produced. and this combination goes on. So if we take one particular gene from each of the segment, this particular process will be able to produce large number of antibody receptors and also T cell receptors. So this production of large number of TCR and BCR is called as generation of diversity. Over here we can see all possible combinations, right? All possible combination which happens during immunoglobulin production and which happens during alpha beta T cell receptor production. And we can see over here, because of this combination of multiple genetic loci, the possible number of diversity in immunoglobulin is 5 multiplied by 10 to the power 13, and in case of T cell receptor it is 10 to the power of 18. So such a large number of receptors are produced by immune system, and during this production it is quite possible that some of the receptors are produced which may react with self antigen. So this is called as central and peripheral tolerance. Now central tolerance begins with bone marrow, where all immune cells are generated, and especially B lymphocyte mature. So during this maturation, if B cell encounters with the cells which contains multivalent self antigen, they are specialized cells present for the development of B cell, and if they react, then such type of B cells are destroyed in bone marrow. Then another central tolerance is induced at the level of thymus. We know that T cells, after getting produced from bone marrow, will migrate to thymus for further development and maturation. During this maturation process, they go through development and selection. So there are two important mechanisms which happen in thymus. One is MHC restriction, that is also called as positive selection. Those T cells who can react efficiently, optimally with MHC are selected, while rest of the cells are destroyed. Once that selection is over, they are once again assigned to another selection, which is called as self induction or self tolerance. Over here, the developing T lymphocyte would interact with the cell containing self antigens. And during this, if the cell would react with the self antigen, they are destroyed. So there is an induction of a tolerance, and this process is called as negative selection. The T cell which would pass both positive selection and negative selection will mature and will go into peripheral lymphoid organs for immune response. Now another part is peripheral tolerance. As we discussed earlier, some of the cell may escape central tolerance and they are there in peripheral lymphoid organs, which may induce autoimmune disease if they mount immune response against self antigen. So there are few mechanisms by which peripheral tolerance is induced. The first is ignorance. In this ignorance, the self-reactive cells may not encounter self antigen. There are mechanisms in which self antigen would not get exposed to the self-reactive T cell. So this is called as ignorance. Next mechanism is energy. If at all the self-reactive cells react with self-antigen, then there would be lack of a co-stimulatory signals, and without absence of such type of co-stimulatory signals, there will not be appropriate activation of particular T lymphocyte. So even they react, they try to get stimulated, but they are being controlled, and this is called as energy. Third mechanism is phenotypic screen. Over here, the self-reactive cell would react with self-antigen, they get stimulated, and even after getting stimulated, they secrete cytokines. But there are mechanisms by which it is totally controlled, and this cell will not be able to produce appropriate cytokines. So cytokines which they produce are non-pathogenic and will not mount any immune response or inflammation. This is phenotypic screen. The fourth is that in spite of activation of a self-reactive cell, after combining with self-antigen, they get activated and they are producing inflammation or injury, the T cell would induce the receptor which will stimulate apoptosis. So, auto-stimulation induced death will happen and the self-reactive T cell would die. So, these are certain mechanisms by which the peripheral self-reactive T cells are controlled. Over and above, there are certain T lymphocytes which functions as T regulatory cell, which will also stop autoimmune response. There is one more mechanism, as we discuss in ignorance, called as sequestered antigen theory. Some of the proteins of our body will never be exposed to immune system, like thyroid gland protein or lens protein or sperm. There are several examples of that. These are sequestered in some of the tissue. So these are the hidden antigens or sequestered antigens, and they will never be exposed to immune cells and they will not lead to any type of immune response. But self-reactive cells, T and B lymphocytes, are there in the body, but they are not able to contact such type of self-antigen. But what happens in case of any infection or a trauma, such type of antigens are exposed to self-reactive B and T lymphocyte, and this will mount autoimmune response or breakage of cell tolerance. Now we have discussed what is immune tolerance, right? So immune tolerance is basically unresponsiveness of immune system towards the self antigen. Now what is the importance of immune tolerance or self tolerance? In case of organ transplantation, if we talk about what we need, we don't want that organ to be rejected, right? So in spite our immune system will identify that as a foreign antigen, foreign tissue, it will mount immune response, but we need to induce tolerance in such type of transplantation, right? And it will increase the lifespan of transplant. So there are certain conditions like organ transplantation in which we would like to induce tolerance. The tumor, as we discussed, the immune system will identify the abnormal antigen. But what happens in tumor? These tumor antigens are basically induce a tolerance, and immune system will not mount immune response against that. So we'd like to remove that tolerance in case of tumor and cancer. And if we do that, the immune system will be able to effectively clear the tumor from the body. Autoimmune disease, once again, over here, the body has mount immune response against the self antigen. So there is a loss of a tolerance, and in this condition, would like that the self tolerance is induced. In case of allergy, once again, our body would mount excessive immune response against commonly encountered antigen. And once again, our aim is to induce the tolerance against such type of common allergens. Vaccination, right? Over here, we don't want the antigen which is given through the vaccine is not tolerated by, but body should mount immune response against the specific antigen. So this is all about immune tolerance. Once again, immune tolerance is non-responsiveness of our immune system against the specific self antigen. It can be of two types, one central tolerance and peripheral tolerance. The B cell self-tolerance is induced in bone marrow. T cell self-tolerance is induced in thymus. In spite of this central thymic tolerance and central bone marrow tolerance, some cells escape. So for that, there are mechanisms by which there is an induction of a tolerance in peripheral lymphoid tissue. So with that, we complete our discussion on immune tolerance. Thank you. So thank you very much. Immune tolerance is very important to understand basis of autoimmune disease. Thank you.